Good evening, dear listeners, and welcome to Basilisk Radio Station. Our first bit of news today comes from Hogwarts, where the annual Spring Spellcraft Fair is in full swing, showcasing innovative charms and enchantments crafted by talented students. Over in Diagon Alley, the Magical Menagerie has just received a rare shipment of singing larks, perfect companions for the budding spring season. Meanwhile, the Ministry of Magic has announced enhanced security measures for the upcoming Walpurgis Night celebrations, ensuring a safe and festive event for all. And turning our eyes to the skies, our weather seer predicts a delightful stretch of mild and sunny weather, ideal for outdoor potions brewing. We'll be back in 25 minutes with more news from the wizarding world. Rejoining you on Basilisk Radio Station with more magical updates. In Quidditch news, the Puddlemere United team is preparing for their next match, hoping to defend their title against the Falmouth Falcons this coming weekend. From the Edinburgh Magical Library, a fascinating exhibition on ancient druidic rituals and their influence on modern magic has just opened, drawing scholars and curious minds alike. In Azkaban, the wardens have reported a stable and calm season, with no incidents thanks to the new security enchantments introduced last month. Stay with us for more enchanting tales and updates.
Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome back to Basilisk Radio Station. Exciting developments in magical healthcare at St. Mungo's Hospital, where a new tonic has been developed to boost magical energy and resilience. In Diagon Alley, Florian Fortescue's ice cream parlour is celebrating the arrival of spring with a new range of floral-flavoured ice creams, including lavender and rose petal. Over in Manchester, the Mystic Pages Bookshop is hosting a signing event with the author of the 1000 Potions series, promising to reveal secret recipes. More wizarding wonders to be shared shortly, so keep those dials tuned.
Thank you.
back on Basilisk Radio Station, bringing you the latest from our magical world. Hogwarts Herbology Department has just unveiled an astonishing new garden maze, planted with rare magical plants that are said to bloom spectacularly on the Walpurgis night. Meanwhile, the Department of Magical Transportation is trialling a new network of flu stations for easier access to festivities across the country. In entertainment, the Wizarding Theatre in London is premiering a play about the legendary witch Morgana as she battles mythical creatures. Stay tuned as we bring you more from the wizarding world.
Thank you.
joining you one last time today on Basilisk Radio Station. As the spring season unfolds, the magical community is bustling with activity. Hogwarts is set to host a grand ball featuring magical performances and fireworks. The Wizarding Farmers Market in Hogsmeade has opened its gates, offering a variety of magical herbs and potions ingredients freshly harvested this spring. Gringotts reports a stable magical economy as we move into the second quarter of the year, with investments in magical green artifacts on the rise. This is Robert Radcliffe, signing off from Basilisk Radio Station. I extend my deepest gratitude to our patrons for their continued support, which fuels our magical broadcasts. Until we meet again, keep the magic alive this spring.